Ma'am has done BMS and MD in Jagjagun Vidyan from Turak Ayurved Mahavidyalaya. Ma'am has also done MA in Sanskrit. Ma'am is owner and director of Ayushkamiya Chikitsale, Pune since 2004. Ma'am was a part of research team contributing to ambitious project entitled Ayurvedia Triskandakosh undertaken by Turak Maharashtra Vidyapit, Pune. Ma'am has also worked as research associate from July 2005 to June 2008. Presently, ma'am is working on a project, Critical Translation of Hasti Ayurveda, that is Ayurveda for Elephants. Ma'am has also been in teaching since 1999. She has been taking private coaching for Indian as well as foreign students in Sanskrit and Ayurveda. She is also a faculty member of International Ayurveda Academy since 2012. Ma'am has worked as honorary lecturer at Turak Maharashtra Vidyapit Pune for postgraduate diploma in Ayurvedic Dietetics, diploma in Abhyanga Mardana Tantrajnan, diploma in Yoga and Ayurved Basic as well as Advanced. Ma'am has also contributed as lecturer and visiting faculty at various institutions for different courses. Ma'am has many research articles published. She has published an article on Ayurveda home remedies in the seminar of Bias, articles on Ayurveda in Soshwa Sandesh, which is a quarterly newsletter published by one of the reputed NGO named Soshwa, article on Udavarta published in Madhujivan, articles on Ayurvedic diet and Ayurvedic pediatrics published in Arogyadesh. Ma'am has participated as visited Middlesex University UK in 2007 for preparing one of its kind dry herbarium of Ayurvedic herbs. She has presented paper on Ayurvedic functional food with special reference to right formulations mentioned in classical texts of Ayurveda at the conference in Netherlands in September 2018. She has carried out workshops and consultations on diet and lifestyle management, women's health, etc. in Austria and Portugal. She has recently presented a paper on Hasti Ayurveda and Sanskrit department, Mumbai University, and also delivered speech on Sanskrit and undiscovered treasure at Indian Studies Center. I would also like to convey sir on his birthday from EI. Happy to have such an eminent and over to you, ma'am.
Thank you, Akshata, for such a nice introduction. Am I audible? Hello?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. First of all, good afternoon to everybody, all the practitioners and students present here. In the beginning, I would like to congratulate E-Ayurshala Ayurveda Academy for arranging such a nice lecture series on the theme of Kalpabhyas. It is really a necessity of all of us, actually I would say myself also, everyone, to understand a Kalpa, whatever we are using in our practice, in our clinics. So it's an ongoing process actually, it never ends. What understanding what we are doing and what we need to do in our clinics, it's an ongoing process. So it's really a nice thing that we will thoroughly understand the Kalpas, which are some of them, but at least we will understand them thoroughly, how we are using and why we are using, etc. So we'll start with the presentation. We had a subject called Vaishajya Kalpana. We had it in the second year of our curriculum. Now these new students or these new practitioners must be having like in third year or like that. But Vaishajya Kalpana we had is this in our curriculum. And we used to study it in various ways. But one of the very common way of understanding the Kalpa or memorizing the Kalpa used to be making some various different sentences to remember the ingredients in that. And now when we, it's really funny Now when we are doing practice, it was not thorough understanding, but we are now trying to understand it thoroughly, this kalpas which are there, which we are using. So what is a kalpa? First of all, the name of the series is Kalpabhyas. So what is a kalpa or what is kalpana? We have kalpasthan in Ashtanga Hrudaya, Kalpasiddhisthan and Ashtanga Hrudaya and Ashtanga Sangraha, and we have kalpasthan in Charaka Samhita. So first of all, we will understand what is the meaning of kalpa or kalpana. So kalpa or kalpana, if we go to dictionary meaning of this word, is kalpa or kalpana, it's a way, it's a method. The dictionary meaning of these words is way, method, preparing, forming, making or arranging. Kalpaha or kalpana is whatever we are preparing, we are forming, we are making or arranging the bhaishajya, that is the kalpa. Basically, in this kalpa or kalpana, there is a root verb. Some of you may be knowing something about Sanskrit. So root verb is dhatu. If you remember something about this, that is dhatu. Dhatu is klupa. Klupa is a dhatu, which means this dhatu is Sanskrit dhatu. This dhatu is not a dhatu like rasa, rakta, mausa, meda, etc. So what does this dhatu mean? This dhatu means that to be fit or adequate for. So kalpa, any kalpa, is not just a mixture of many herbs or many medicines. It's a mixture which should be adequate, which should be fit for the disease or the avastha which you are using. So it should be fit, it should be adequate, it should be enough to cure, or it should be a good solution, proper solution, the right solution, apt solution for whatever you want to do, for the purpose for which you are doing it, you are using it. So that is the meaning of kalpa, actually, if you go by Sanskrit meaning. So klupa kalpa is the basic dhatu or the root word in it. So it means that whatever you prepare, whatever you arrange, whatever you mix, or whatever you do the samskar, that is the processing on that kalpa, it should be adequate, it should be fit, it should be enough for serving the purpose for whatever you are doing, whatever you want to serve the purpose, whatever you want to do with this kalpa. So going further, if we want to learn the kalpa, or if we want to study the kalpa properly, what should you do? Some lectures I have attended in this series, and many of them have told about it. I will repeat it again here, that if we want to study a kalpa, what should be the process of studying it? Should we take the kalpa, we should read it, we should go through the ingredients, the phalashruti, the rogadhikar, and that will be enough? No. First of all, what is needed to understand a kalpa thoroughly is given in this stanza or in this verse, that rogamadav parikshetra tatonantaram aushadam tatakarma bhishak paschat jnanapurvam samacharyat. So what we need to do, rogamadav parikshetra, first of all, everyone has told this, adav, in the beginning you have to do the examination of the roga, tatonantaram aushadam, then you have to examine the aushadam. So the physician should do whatever he wants to treat the disease. After that, use that kalpa with the proper knowledge, with the proper reasoning. So rogamadho parikshita, in this, we are knowing the disease, and equally is important, you have to include it in the roga, the word roga, rugna also. So vyadhi and vyadhita. So you have to understand the vyadhi properly, and also you have to understand the vyadhita, because it is very important to understand the vyadhita, that is the rugna, because we are studying the roga, the vyadhi, from the text that you may be studying from Madhav Niran, or you may be studying it from classical text like Charakshushrut Vakvat. So you are studying the roga, you are studying the vyadhi. But many a times we see that there is no book picture. In the when a patient approaches us, we see that there is not the book picture. If we have studied many vyadhis very deeply, or everything may not help you in the clinic. So you have to study the rugana also, the vyadhi, the person also. So rogam adav parikshita, first of all you have to examine the roga, and equally important you are including another word in this roga, that rugana, the vyadhita. So how you are going to examine it, examining the person, a patient, so that also it has been spoken about in the in this lecture series, that we have seen it. Dusham desham balam kalam analam prakrutim vaya sattvam sattvam tatha harmavastha shukutakusapita sukshma sukshma samiksesham doshoshad nirupane yo vartate chikitsayam natas kalutishapiche. So doshoshad nirupana for fixing the dosha, dusha and aushadha for it, you have to understand the rugana, the vyadhi, from where he is living and what is the rutu, that is the season where when he has approached us, etc. So rogam and rugana, so roga, the disease, and the diseased person, that is vyadhita, we are examining. Tatonantaram aushadam, then we have to examine the aushadam. How will we examine the aushadam? Is there any method to examine the aushadam? I just keep on asking questions, so though we are not before each other, still it gives some stimulation to our thinking process. So I will keep on asking questions. I don't expect any answer, of course, from you, but it gives a stimulation to our thinking process. So how will you, how will we examine the aushadha? Is there any stanza, any verse, any reference told in our classical text? So yes, it is there. It is in Charaka Vimanasthan 8th Adhyaya. If you remember that they have any, whenever we are doing any work, in Charaka Vimanasthan 8th Adhyaya, they have told that you have to go through 10 Dashavidha Pariksha. So they have told that Karana, Karana, Karya Yoni, Karya Phala. So in that they have told is Karana is Bhishak, Karana is Punar Bheshajam, Karanam Punar Bheshajam, Karana is Bheshajam. So how is this Bheshajam examined? How you should know properly, thoroughly about this Bheshajam or Aushadam? So what they tell is there that with the permission of organizers, I am trying to elaborately tell what is, how to understand the kalpa, then we will move to dadi madhyamakam. So okay, so yattu dravya bhutam tad gamanadishi yogam. So whatever dravya bhuta medicine or bhishaja, how we should examine it, what they have told is idam evam prakrutya. So iska swabhav kya hai, idam evam gunam, iske gun kya hai, what are the attributes of this, idam evam prabhavam, what are the prabhav which can't be explained on the basis of the attributes. So iska prabhav kya hai, asmin desha jatam, where it has been grown, kis desh mein iska iski nirmit ye bada hai, ye grow hua hai, asmin rato, is rutu mein ye bada hai, is rutu mein it has grown in this season, and it has been collected evam gruhitam, is prakar se ye collect kiya gaya, evam nihitam, in this way it was kept, in this way it was processed, upaskruta, upaskruta evam upaskrutam, in this way it was processed, and anaya matraya, and in this quantity it was used, yuktam asmin vyadhau, in this disease it was used, evam vidhasya purushasya, it was this used in this type of a person or a patient, it was used, etavantam dosham apakarshayati. So this expels out this much amount of dosha from the body, or it upashamayati va, or it pacifies this much amount of dosha. Yatcha anyadapi bheshajam bhavet tatcha anena visheshana yuktam, and any other medicine which is similar to this, that also you have to study. So when you say that I want to examine, I want to know Aushadha thoroughly, you have to follow all this process which is told in Charakavimanasthan Ekthadhyay. So whatever I am telling you, I am saying that it's a discussion now. You are all, most of you, you are practitioners, and it's like we can call it Tadvidya Sambhasha. So it's a type of discussion, and it's a co-learning process. So next slide, we will go to the next slide. So in the co-learning process of ours. So now coming to Dadi Madi Grutta, we will first of all see the references of Dadi Madi Grutta, where it has been told. So first of all, references which we all know are from Pandurova Chikitsa. So one reference we get from Charaka Chikitsa Sthan, 16th Adhyay, 16th chapter. It's 44 to 46 stanzas or verses are there for Pandurova Chikitsa. Ashtanga Sahara Chikitsa, in 18th chapter, it is told Dadi Madi Grutta is, we find the reference of Dadi Madi Grutta, and the third reference we find in Ashtanga Hruday Chikitsa Sthan in Pandurova Chikitsa. So all these three references which I have put in this slide are from Pandurova Chikitsa. Of course, I was working on Triskandha Kosh, so it's a very gigantic project and it gives lot of references which we are not thinking about, which we may miss while reading the Samhitas, but Triskandha Kosh helps us to go to these minute and small references. So there are some more Dadi Madi Grutta, I will just mention them here. How to study any kalpa, that I am just telling. So Dadi Madi Grutta, there are some other references also. Some other references which we get from Chardi Rudrova Krishna Chikitsa. Dadi Madi Grutta is told in that Adhikar also, Chardi Rudrova Krishna Adhikar, for pacifying Vataja Chardi. For Vataja Chardi, they have told a Dadi Madi Grutta which contains some contents are same, like Dadima is there, Shunti is there, also Dadhi is added there. So in Charak Vakhat Chikitsa 6th chapter, it is told in Chardi Rudrova Krishna Chikitsa, in that Adhikar for Vataja Chardi. Another reference of Dadi Madi Grutta we get in Kasa Chikitsa, Kshaya Kasa, it is there in Vakhvat, that is Ashtanga Hruday also, and it is there in Sangraha, Ashtanga Sangraha also. So Kshatakshaya Adhikar or Kshaya Jakasa, we find another reference of Dadi Madi Grutta here. So this is another Dadi Madi Grutta in which there is Trikatu and Dadima, etc. Another reference we get of Dadi Madi Grutta is from Sangraha Chikitsa Shotha Adhikar. So that is another Dadi Madi Grutta which we are going to talk about now. Here is Dadi Madi Grutta and Pandurova Chikitsa. So we'll now go further to the next slide. So we are going to talk about the Grutta, Dadi Madi Grutta. So first of all, we'll see the stanza. Most of you must be knowing this, must have read it or memorized it by heart in our college days also. It is Dadima Kudavo Dhanyat Kudavartham Palam Palam Chitraka Shungaveracha Pippalyashtamikatatha Taihi Kalkaihi Vimshati Palam Vrutasya Salilarathe Siddham Rutbarsha Gulmarsha Lihavata Kapartinus Deepanam Shwasakasadanam Murhavatecha Shasyate Dukha Prasamini Namcha Vandhyanamcha Iva Garbhadam. So there are the ingredients spoken of. Ingredients are Dadima, Kudavarte, there are everything we are going to see later. So this type of Grutta is prepared, it's medicated, and it is useful in various ailments or various conditions or diseases like Shwaskas, Murhavat, Dukha Prasavini and Vandhya. For Dukha Prasavini, I will say something. Dukha Vandhya, you can understand that in infertility, female infertility, it can be used. Dukha Prasavini Nam, in the commentary, of Dukkha Prasuvininam in Ashtanga Sangraha, it is said that Ya Dukkhena Prasuvyate. But so there is a confusing thing that it should be used if there is a problem in conceiving, it should be used, or if there is a problem in delivery, it should be used. So my opinion is, though they have said dukkha dukkhena prasuyante, who have problem in conceiving, I'll say vandhya is total infertility. They are not conceiving at all. And dukkha prasuvini is that they have not a problem only in prasuti, but a problem in getting conceived. That is, not conceived, that they are getting conceived, but some problem happens, like there is some abnormality in the fetus, so they have to abort the fetus, or there are some fetal abnormalities seen. So the female is conceived and it goes smoothly up to the delivery, that doesn't happen. So that may be the meaning. I don't know what is the meaning, because I haven't used in dukkha prasivini type of, or I haven't thought of it. But if I have to interpret it, dukkha prasivini, I will interpret not related to delivery, but related to mainly after conception, up to delivery, there may be having some problems like garbhapas rao or other problems that related to the fetal abnormalities like IUGR or whatever are there. So I actually don't know the meaning of, and it is not found properly in the tikas. Now, before going further to the ingredients and their efficacy, and how it is, how we can say that this kalpa is efficient in this type of ailment or disease. Before that, first of all, I would like to explain or say something about this type of formulation. This type of formulation is Sneha Paka Kalpana. And in Sneha Paka Kalpana, there are various Sneha Paka Kalpana which we can prepare with various Sneha. Ruta, Taila, Vasa, Majja. These are the main Sneha which we can say that they are called Shrestha, the best ones. With those, Ruta, Taila, Vasa, Majja, we can prepare Sneha Paka. And sometimes we can prepare Sneha Paka, that is Siddha Sneha, with Yamaka Sneha, that is two of them together, Trivrut Sneha, three of them together, or Mahasneha, that is four of them, all of them together. So in this way, Sneha Paka Kalpana is prepared. But in this context, in here, in the context of Dadimadi Gruta, we are going to talk about Gruta Kalpana. So Sneha Paka Kalpana and Gruta Kalpana. So first of all, we should know what is the importance of Sneha Paka Kalpana and what is the importance of Gruta Kalpana, which we are talking about. Most of the times I have seen in practice of many people that churna, guti, vati, kwath, prepared, like ready kwath, etc. are used a lot. And it is said that it is the end user, that is the patient's ease. For the ease of the patient, we don't use Sneha Kalpana, Sneha Paka Kalpana, or Gruta Kalpana, Taila Kalpana to the extent which it should be used. Why it should be used and what is the reason and the thinking behind it, I will elaborate, I will tell about it. So, as I told you, I have been working, I have worked on Triskandha Kosha project, and just out of curiosity yesterday, as I am going to present this Dadimadi Gruta, I was going to present today. So just out of curiosity, I just thought I should just get the count, get the number of various kalpas from Gruhatray. So I have got Aushadha Kosh with me. So I just referred the Aushadha Kosh. In Aushadha Kosh, in the Parishishta, I don't know some of you have referred Tirthankarash. Are you using Tirthankarash? I don't know. But if you are not using, you can use it. Helps a lot in practice. So when I referred this, I saw in this Tirthankarash, that is Aushadhakosh, there are Tirthankarash, that is Hetukosh, Lakshankosh and Aushadhakosh. So I saw for this Dadimadhi Ghruta and all those Sneha Kapaka Kalpana and Ghruta Kalpana in Tirthankarash. So in Tirthankarash, I just counted last night, I counted the numbers of various kalpas. So it was not very surprising for me, I was expecting the number. So I found out that Ghruta Kalpana are 1185 Ghruta Kalpanas are there. I counted every Ghruta Kalpana, so there may be Dadimadhi Ghruta may have come thrice, same Dadimadhi Ghruta, but I just counted the number, I just wanted to know the number. So I counted the Ghruta Kalpanas, so they were 1185. Churna Kalpanas I counted, they were 720. Taila Kalpanas I counted, they were 722. Vasa Kalpanas I counted, they were 683. Avaleha Kalpanas I counted, they were 596. Butika, various Butika, tablets, Kalpana I counted, they were 138. There are many other Kalpanas in Aushadhakosh. We can see that Agadha Kalpana, Akshara Kalpana, so Arishta, I didn't have time that much to count every. But I am sure that the number of Kalpana, that is the Ghruta Kalpana, is the highest in Bhruvatray. So number of Taila Kalpana is below that. So the second number, on first number there is Ghruta Kalpana, on second number there is Taila Kalpana, Taila Kalpana. So we can see, and afterwards all Churna Kalpana, Swatha Kalpana, Avaleha Gutika, etc., Asava, Arishta, they are all coming. So they are very less in number. So what we are using in our practices, I know that this thing is for clinical practice. I am expected to talk more about Dadimadhi Ghruta, but I am coming to that point. But I think this is very important to understand for every practitioner, that why, what we are doing and what should be done. Some, I am not saying about all, some may be using this Sneha Kalpana and Ghruta Kalpana etc. a lot in their practices, but most of the times what I have seen and what I want to emphasize is that Ghruta Kalpana and Taila Kalpana are the highest numbers, especially Ghruta Kalpana, in the classical text. I am not saying anything about this Bhishuddha Ratnavali, they are good books, Sahasra Yoga etc., but I am referring to the classical text, the Bhruvatray. So Ghruta Kalpana is the highest number and Sneha Kalpana overall is the highest number in this counting it was found out. And it was not very surprising for me. So why this Sneha Kalpana is important, why this Ghruta Kalpana is important, and why is this number so high in the Bhruvatray? So we will first of all go to next slide and then I will talk about all these things again. So Sneha Paka Kalpana, as we saw that Sneha Paka Kalpana, Sneha Ghruta Taila Masamaja are the main Snehas, important Snehas, which have which are concentrated with the Snigdha Guna. So they are the best as compared to the dhi, that is curds and milk and etc. So first of all, we'll go through the effects of Snehana. Effects of Snehana, what are they? Snehana, there are various references of Snehana. One, Snehana is one of the treatment modality or therapeutic modality. We have studied six upakrama: Snehana, Rukshana, Langana, Bruhana, Svedana, Sambhana. So one of them, important one, is Snehana. So what does that do? Snehana, what does it do? Snehana, Sneha Vishyanda Mardava Kledakaratam. That we know from Charak Sutras. What does Snehana do? What are the effects of Snehana in the body? It gives Sneha, it gives anxiousness or oleation to the body parts. It gives Abhishanda, it creates Abhishanda, moistens the body parts. It gives rise to oozing or trickling. Abhishanda ko janam deta hai, Abhishanda nirman karta hai. Mardava, that is, it gives softness to the body parts, it softens the body parts. Kleda karakam, as just we saw that it's creating the kleda. Then what does Sneha do? Another some stanzas we will go through before going to Dadimadhi Ghruta. स्नेहो नीलम हंती मृदु करुति देहम मलानाम मिलिहंती संगम. दिस इज फ्रॉम चरक सिद्धिस्थान. स्नेहो नीलम हंती मृदु करोति देहम मलानाम मिलिहंती संगम स्निग्धस्य सूक्ष्मेषु अयनेषु लीनम स्वेदस्तु दोषम नयति द्रवत्वम. सो स्नेहो अनिलम हंती. स्नेह एनी इट मे बी घृत, इट मे बी वसा, इट मे बी मज्जा, इट मे बी तैल. इट पैसिफाइज वाटर, इट गिव्स सॉफ्टनेस टू द बॉडी, इट गिव्स इट रिमूव्स एज वी सॉ हियर, इट रिमूव्स द संग मल संग नाशन, इट रिमूव्स द बाइंडिंग द मलज दैट इज द दोषेस आर बॉर्न टू वेरियस शाखा मर्म एटसेट्रा दूष ऑर्गन एंड दे आर स्टिकिंग देर. सो वेन वी गिव स्नेह ना, स्नेह by giving softness to the body part, it makes a situation, a condition in the body that the malas which are sticking there, they are removed, they get separated. And this reference is from Siddhisthan. First reference was from Sutrasa. So it is telling only about whatever in general snehanatu. This second reference is from Siddhisthan. We know that Siddhisthan is for understanding vamana and virechana and all the things related to that. So here it is important to emphasize on the function of sneha in context with the vamana and virechana, that is shodhana prakriya. So here it is important to tell, it was important to tell that what does it do in that context. So it removes the sangha of mala, that is the mala is sticking to various body parts, and it removes that sangha without removing that sangha, without separating it, separating the doshas from wherever they are sticking to. You can't go further, you can't move to the shodhana, that is vaman or virechan karna hai. So pehle snehan is very very important, inevitable, snehan karna hi hai. Uske baad, after that, the whatever you are doing, that will be fruitful, that will give you good results. Otherwise, aap hani kar rahe ho sharir, you are giving some harm to the body. So, some other things from Vagbhat also we can, we all know. Diptantara agnihi parishuddha koshtaha pratyakta dhatur valavarana yuktaha dhudendriyo mandajara shatayu sneho pasevi purusha pradishtaha. Whatever the purusha, that person who gets snehana chikitsa or who gets consuming sneha, that is oil or ghee or other snehas, he is shatayu, he has long life. The sneha gives strength to dhatus and the body, strengthens the senses, mrudu karana, it softens the body parts, it kindles the digestive fire, agni deepan hai, prolongs the onset of aging, varanya, ayush. So these many are the effects of sneha. Next, we will go to Vruta. We will just go fast to the attributes of Vruta. Doshodhanata is Vatagna, Kapagna, Kendal, Digestive Fire. So most of them are like similar to Sneha, but some are different. Nourishes dhatus, especially Rasa, Rakta, Shukra, softens body parts, soothing, beneficial for health of eyes, old persons, children, debilitated persons, and persons desiring healthy progeny, etc., etc. Enhances poison, etc. It's good for wounds, poisons, toxic effects, enhances the strength of the sensory organs. All these attributes and functions of Vruta are there. Now coming back to the importance of Sneha Kalpana, as I told you in Bruhatrayi, I found out more than 1000 Vruta Kalpana and more than 700 Saila Kalpana and other Vasa etc. I didn't count. Yamaka Sneha, Trivrut Sneha etc. I didn't count. But it's a high count. So what does that mean? Why is it so? So for understanding Dadima Adhikruta, this is all important. What I am making your foundation, I am making the background of Dadima Adhikruta. So why is this important? Why this Sneha Chikitsa is important? What do we achieve by giving this Snehana or Sneha Chikitsa? So Sneha, what is Sneha in the body? Sneha, I am just getting a pause, just you should think. Sneha jo hai, Sneha ko hi bal bola hai. Sneha jo hai, wo deha ka saar hai. So whatever concentrated good things, best things in the body are Sneha. Sneha sharir ka bal hai. Sneha hi oj ko bhi Sneha bola hai. स्नेह देहसार है, राजेश मां की चिकित्सा जब शुरू की है, इन दैट दे हैव सेड दैट स्नेह परीक्षयात, इंदोह स्नेह परीक्षयात, इंदु जो चंद्र था उनका स्नेह का परीक्षय हो गया, तो उनकी बॉडी कम होते गई, ही लॉस्ट हिज वेट यू कैन से, ही बिकेम क्रुशल, एंड इन द कॉमेंट्री यू कैन सी दैट स्नेह मीन इट्स देहसार, देहसार स्नेह क्षय वॉज देहसार क्षय. So this much importance is given to Sneha and it is there, it's not only given. So when we are treating a patient, Snehana Chikitsa becomes a very important Chikitsa. Whatever we are doing in patient, as we all know that Prayoga Sumayad Vyadhi Nekam Yonya Mudhiraye Lato Vishuddha Shuddha Sumayad Yona Kopaye. So the treatment which pacifies or subsides one disease and gives rise to another is not Shuddha Chikitsa. So it's very important while we are treating any patient, it may be a patient of Prameha, it may be a patient of Udar, it may be a patient or simple any disease, it, or maybe Jwara also, in Jwara it is talked of that Baladishthanam Arogyam Sadarthoyam Priyakramana. So whatever we are treating is for bala of the patient. So bala adhisthanam arogyam, arogya, that is the health, is dependent, is supported on bala of the patient, the strength of the patient. And whatever we are doing is for the strength, establishing the strength of the patient. So our chikitsa, most of the times we see that gutika, swas, etc., they are not, I'm not saying that that treatment type is bad, but we are using kalpanas which don't have sneha in that, and that can create rukshana and balanasha or balahani. So we have to be cautious about this, that while we are treating, like you maybe in my practice I do very little things like kalpas like Chandra Prabha and Gubbulu Kalpa and many many. All these kalpas, Arogya Vardhini, Sudshekhar Rasa Kalpa, they are very less in my practice. While we are using, we should be very cautious. Chandra Prabha, for example, is very Ruksha Kalpa. So while we are using such kalpas, such formulations, we should be cautious always that what we are not giving rise to any other disease when we are treating the patient. So Sneha Kalpana in that context, in that view, is very important, that Sneha gives bala to the body. And we can, when Sneha Kalpana, what is Sneha Kalpana or what is Druta Kalpana? We are medicating the various herbs or medicines, whatever we are, Jangama, Udbhuta, Parthya, whatever we are using, and we are medicating it. So whatever aushadha which we have selected is going with sneha, that is whatever the thing which is going to give or which is going to maintain the strength, the bala of the body. So in this sense, this sneha na chikitsa is very important. I am coming, in next slide I will come to and talk about speciality of Druta Kalpana, specificity, distinctive things about Druta Kalpana afterward. So what is the purpose of Snehan as a therapeutic modality? What is the purpose of Snehan? In effects of Snehan, we saw that we want to give Sneha, anxiousness or oleation to the body, etc. We saw that. But as a therapeutic modality, when we are using Snehan, what we want to do, what we want to create, so it is used for Shodhana, it is used for Shamana, or it is used for Brahmana. So various purposes, to serve these purposes, we are using this Snehana Chikitsa as a therapeutic modality. So for this Snehana Chikitsa, we are choosing two ways or two modes of giving Snehana to the patient. We may use Achchapana, that all of you know, and we may use Vicharana Sneha. So Achchapana, in that there is Pradhana Matra, Madhyama Matra and Rasva Matra. In Vagbhata also it is told, in Charaka Samhita also it is told with Pradhanamantri Mind Matra, and in which conditions, for which patients, and for which purpose you should use Pradhanamatra, Madhya Matra, and Sarsva Matra. All the things are told there. If we time permits, we may talk about it afterwards, but we have to go further because we are running out of time, I think. So, Pradhana, Madhyama and Rasva Matra are given for Achchapan. Achchapan, you remember, all of you remember, Achchapan is Kevala Sneha. It is said that Sneha se Kalpastu Shrestha. Ye Shrestha Kalpa hai, Sneha ka. Mane sabse zyada Sneha. Its fullest, you can say, is achieved by Achchapan. Achchapan se pure shareer ko puri tarah siddhata mil paati hai. Ye Achchapan jo hai, that is called as Shrestha Kalpa, Shrestha method, best method of giving Sneha to the body. And it has again three quantities which can be given, Pradhana, Madhyama and Rasva. And another mode of giving Sneha now, or giving this treatment to the patient is Vicharana Sneha. There are 24 Vicharana Sneha. Odanashtu Vilepi, you all know that it's with the Odana Vilepi, Rasva Mausam Mausaras, Dude, Yavagu, etc. ke saath, ya Abhyanga Basti, Nasya Gandush, Paranapuran, Uttar Basti. In these modes also, in these methods also, you can administer say Sneha in the body. So this is ye gaur hai Sneha Kalpa jo shrestha bataya Achchapan se. Now with this background of Snehana Bhruta Kalpana, I have left something topic to talk about Bhruta Kalpana, but Sneha Paka, what is the importance of Sneha, what is the importance of Bhruta Kalpana. With all this background and our foundation, we are now coming to Dadi Madhi Bhruta. So first of all, we will see the content in the ingredients of Dadi Madhi Bhruta. Dadima Dhanyaka, as we have seen the verse of the stanza, Dadima Dhanyaka Chitraka Shunki Pitali, Gruta and water are the contents. See, you can see that contents are not lot, not many. In some Grutas or some Kwatha or Gushika or in many, there are lot of contents. Ingredients. So here the ingredients, the number of ingredients is limited. Quantity of ingredients. Dadima is 1 pudava, 160 grams approximately. Dhanyaka is half pudava, 80 grams approximately. Chitraka is pala, 40 grams approximately. Shunti is pala, 40 grams approximately. Pippali is ashtamika, that is 20 grams. Bhruta is 20 pala and water is 266 ml. So, or aduka. So, process of preparing this Dadimadi Bhruta, we all know the process of Gruta Siddhi and Taila Siddhi. So we all mix this, mixing all these ingredients and putting it on fire, low fire, etc. And seeing the Siddhi Pariksha, in which we can see that Yada Feno Bhavasele, Feno Shantisha Sarkishi, etc. Feno Shan Ho Jata Hai, Gruta Kalpana Ki Siddhi Mein Ant Mein, etc. That we will see, and that then we will filter this Dadi Madhi Gruta. One thing important I want to tell here, that many times we can see in Bhruhatri that if a particular quantity of any Gruta is told that you have to prepare in this quantity only, it is expected, in Basti also it is like that, it is expected that that whole quantity is for that specific particular patient, one patient. One rugana, ek rugana ke liye wo puri quantity actually hoti hai, that is expected actually in the Bhruhatri. Ye pura ka pura is ek vyakti ke liye use karna hai. You have to use that only for that person. In Basti also they have told whatever that kutaka and etc. and whole quantity has to be used for one person. Aajkal hum we buy 200 ml of Dadi Madhi Bhruta most of the time and use it and give it to the patient, but it's not the real practice in according to Bhruhatri. Efficacy as in the classical text. So, what the stanza we saw, we'll just see the efficacy, what are the diseases it can cure. So it is Vata Kapha and Kapha Agna. So Vata Kapha jo diseases vikara, it can be used. It's Agni Deepan. It's Mudha Vata Anuloman. It is good, or it can be used in Rudra, Pandu, Gulma, Sriha, Srihavruti, Shwas, Kar, Vandhyatva, or difficult delivery. I have just translated Dukha Prasavini, but I don't agree with difficult delivery. As I told you, from conception to delivery, some problems may be happening, so you have to use it before conceiving, actually. What is my interpretation about it? So, the patient shouldn't face these problems, so for that, it should be used before conception. For solving the problems and bija should be, etc., etc. So, that is the meaning of difficult delivery, what I feel about Dukha Prasavini. Now here it is important to understand that this is Pandu, this is in Pandu Adhikar, Pandu Vyadhi, but it can be used in various other diseases or avastha conditions also. But as it has been said previously in this lecture series, that this will not be, may not be, I am not saying always not be, but this may not be a drug of choice, say in Gulma Chikitsa. But if Gulma and Pandu is Vyadhi Sankar, or Pandu is Vyadhi, ek Vyadhi jo hai, dusre Vyadhi ka nidan hota hai. One Vyadhi gives rise to another Vyadhi. So Pandu is the reason of Gulma, and sometimes it is said that hetu ban ke pehla Vyadhi khatam ho jata hai, ya it is there still, it sustains, it is still there. So both of them are there in the body. So in such conditions, this would be a drug of choice, like Vyadhi Sankar hai, ya phir ek Vyadhi Pandu ki vajah se other Vyadhi nirman ho rahe. I am not saying that you will not be able to use it at all, but most of the times we can say that this is the reasoning of Phalashruti, why this particular diseases or elements or avastha come in that Phalashruti. So before proceeding to how it is effective or how it can be used in these diseases which are spoken of in the Phalashruti, before that we'll just have some analysis, have some table presentation of the Rasa Virya Vipak and gunas of all these ingredients. So we will have a look at all these things. I didn't mention the shlokas, etc. So tabular presentation would be more appealing, or more, you can more understand from this table presentation. So Dadima, we first of all see about the Rasa Virya Vipak of the ingredients. So here Dadima, we can say that it is Amla and Madhura. There are various types of Dadima told in various Samhitas. They have told that there is Amla Dadima, Madhura Dadima, Amla Madhura Dadima, and accordingly the functions change. But Amla Dadima and Madhura Dadima, I have taken these two rasas here. So it's slightly mainly Amla or Madhura, slightly Amla and Madhura, we can say. Amla Dadima is more Pittakar, not Pittakar, but it's not that much Pitta Shamana. According to Charashushrut, Adhyayas of Annapana Vidhi, etc. Dhanya ka rasa of Dhanyake is Kashaya Katu and Pitta. Chitrak is Katu, Shungi is Katu, Pittali is Katu. In Vipak, we can see that Dadima, I have written here Madhura Vipak, but anywhere it is not told. You can, in Sushrut they have told Amla Vipaki. They have prepared a group of many fruits like Dadima, and they tell that they are all Amla Vipaki. In Dhanyaka, it is Madhura Vipak, though it is Kashaya Katu, it is Vipaki Madhura. Chitraka, Katu Vipak, कटुरस एंड कटु विपाक. शुंगि इज कटु रस बट विपाक इज मधुर. पिप्पली इज कटु रस बट विपाक इज मधुर. इन वीर्य वी कैन से दैट वी कैन सी दैट एवरी इंग्रेडियंट इज उष्णम. चित्रक इज अग्नि दैट इज वेरी हॉट. इट्स सिनोनिम इज अग्नि एंड ऑल द सिनोनिम्स ऑफ अग्नि कैन बी एप्लीकेबल टू चित्रक. सो इट इज वेरी वेरी हॉट वेरी उष्ण अतिष्ण. Others are not that much usual. So you can see here, is Katuras is Ambala and Katuras is predominant, and Vipak in Vipak Madhura Vipak is predominant, and in Virya all Ushna are there. So Ushna is predominant. Yes. Attributes of ingredients. Some only three I have taken here. Not all, because they are not important in the context of Dari Madhi Vrutta. Others are not that important. These three are more important. So Ruksha, Laghu and Snigdha. We can see that Darima is not Ruksha, Dhanika is not Ruksha, Chitrak is Ruksha and others are not Ruksha. Laghu, all five are Laghu. In Snigdha, all the except Chitrak, all of them are Snigdha. Chitrak is Ruksha Guna. So we can say that 4 Snigdha, 5 Laghu and 1 Ruksha. We put functions of the ingredients in the tabular form. You can see that this Vrutta in the stanza, we saw that Deepanam Swasakasana Moodavatecha Shasyate. So we can see here that it is the proof for that or the reasoning for that. Deepana, it is Dadima, Dhanika, Chitra, Shunki, all are Deepan, Pachan. Four are Pachan, Dadima is not called Pachan. Grahi is also there, all five are told in the Grahi. Rucha, four are there, Grahi, Rucha, Chitra is not told. Wherever I have kept blank spaces, now I haven't written no, no, I haven't written L, because it can be Rucha. Chitra can be Rucha because Agni Deepan ho gaya, so Rucha kaam hota hai. It is mostly related to Agni. So I haven't written N. In Vibandhanut, Vibandhaka Nashan Karna. Shunti ke shlok mein aya hai Vibandhanut. So I have written yes, why? But Pippali can also be Vibandhanut. But there is, it's not told, it's not written there in the shlok or in the verse of Pippali. So I haven't written, written yes, but I haven't written no also. So it can be Vibandhanut. Others also can be Vibandhanut. Amapachan kiya, kafka nash kiya, to Vibandhaka nash ho hi jayega. Isliye Chitrak can also be Vibandhanut. So I haven't written yes also, I haven't written no also. Whatever is there in the stanzas, in Bhavprakash and Bruhatrayi, I have taken all those things and I have written N. So it can be, there is a space, it can be there. Rudya, Darima is Rudya, Shunki is Rudya, Pippali is Rudya. Vrushya, Darima, Shunki, Pippali are Vrushya. Rasayana, Medhya, Rechan, Swarya. They are also, you can see that Darima and Nitsitra are Rasayana and Medhya. But that is not important in this context of Darima Adhikuta. Now coming to the distinguishing attributes of ingredients. After seeing the ingredients, their quantity, their tabular presentation, now we will talk about distinguishing attributes of the ingredients involved in this or which are there in the Dari Madhi Vrutta. Darima is amla but not vistakar. Darima, first of all, Darima is ahariya dravya. We all know, I think, or if we are not knowing, let it be clear to you now that Ahariya Dravya are Rasa Pradhan and Aushadha Dravya are Virya Pradhan, and some are there like which we use as spices. They are sometimes photo also, but not picture. If Vipass is not clearly mentioned in the text everywhere, but we can say that as it is not Sistagra, we can say that it can be Madhura Vipass. So I have put it in the tabular form that it's Madhura Vipass. Shunji is Katu. Shunji and Pippali and Dadimo, these three are aapko rasa ka adhyay yaad hai. Whatever we have learned from first year, you have to all memorize or remember all the things to understand the kalpa. First year ka gyan chhod do, aise nahi hota kabhi. Everything is important to understand the clinical practical. So Shunji, Pippali and Gadimo, these three are the dravyas which are exceptions ones. So Dadi Amla ka kaam kya hota hai? How is Amla rasa? Amla rasa pitta kar hai. Right? But you can see that Dadima is not Pitakara. Shunji is Katu by Rasa, but it's not Katu Rasa Vipas Katu hota hai, but it's not Katu by Vipas. Its Vipas is Madhura and Katu Rasa Dravyas are Avrusha. They deplete Shukra, but Pippali and Shunji are the exceptions. Then don't, this is important, whatever I am telling here in understanding Dadi Madhigota is important to understand the efficacy of Dadi Madhigota. So Shunji is Katu, but Madhura Vipas and Vrusha. Pippali is also Katu, so it must have been Katu Vipas and Avrusha, deplete Shukra. But Katu Pippali is having Madhura Vipas and it is Vrusha. So you can see that Dadima, Shunji and Pippali, these three are the exceptions which are told in Rasa Adhyay. Rasa ka jo adhyay hai, usme ye exceptions bataya hai. So what does that mean? What is the importance of this exception? Hame usse kya samajhna chahiye? Ki exception hai to theek hai, okay. What is the importance? तो अम्ल रस जो है उसके बहुत गुण है फंक्शन से. अम्ल रस जो है अम्लो रसो भक्तम रोचयति अग्निम दीपयति देहम ब्रुवयति ऊर्जयति मनोबोधयति. मन का बोधन करता है, देह का भ्रमण करता है, अग्नि का दीपन करता है, इंद्रियों को दृढ़ बनाता है, बल का वर्धन करता है, वात का अनुलोमातम अनुलोमयति हृदय तर्पयति एक्सेट्रा एक्सेट्रा. भक्तम अपकर्षयति, जो खाया है उसको नीचे लेके जाता है पचा के. क्लेदयति जरयति प्रीणयति. बट एज इट इज पित्त कर इट कैन बी यूज इन एक्सेस. सो स एवं गुण अभी अत्यर्थम बहुत ज्यादा यूज किया तो पित्त को बढ़ाता है और बहुत सारे चीजों को निर्माण करता है, जैसे कि कफम विलापयति पित्तम अभिवर्धयति रक्तम दूषयति मांसम विदेति रक्त का दुष्टि करता है, मांस का विदाह करता है, कायम तो शिथिली करोति काय को शरीर को शिथिल बनाता है. सो व्हेन यू से दैट अम्ल दाड़ी में इज अम्ल बट नॉट पित्त कर, यू आर सेइंग दैट अम्ल रस अच्छे गुण जो है अम्ल रस के अच्छे कर्म वट एवर दे आर यू आर गेटिंग, बट द बैड इफेक्ट ऑफ बिकॉज ऑफ इट्स फंक्शन ऑफ इनिशिएटिंग पित्त दे आर अवॉइडेड. So this is importance of this exception. So amla ras aur pittakar nahi hai. Shunji katu hai. Katu kya hai? Katu ke bahut sare gun hai ki srotaton ka shodhan karta hai, bhuktam shoshayati agnim dipayati chakshur virechayati jo hai rochayati ashan rochayati ashanam kandur vinashayati krimin hinasti krimin ka nash karta hai mausam vilikhati etc. All good functions of Katu Rasa are there, but because of Katu Vipas, you can see that it pustu upahanti, it is avrusha and it gives rise to vata diseases. As we can see that about Shunji and Pippali, they are Katu, but they have Madhur Vipas and they are vrusha. So you get all good things of Katu Rasa and simultaneously you can avoid all the bad effects of Paturasa here in Shunti and Pippali. So they can be used a lot in many kalpas. You can see that they appear in many kalpas, Shunti and Pippali. Shunti is grahi and vibandhu, that is the distinctive attributes of the ingredients. Shunti is jo hai, the grahi and vibandhu hai. So apparently it is like grahi looks opposite of vibandhu. So vibandha ka nash karna aur grahi, ye ek saath kaise ho sakta hai? How it can go together? So grahi is a function, actually it is told in Bhavaprakash also. Grahi is a function on mala. Mala agar patla hai, if purusha is a liquid, so agneya guna bahulya, agneya guna hone ke karan toyaansh parishoshya, uska toya jal ka ansh ka shoshan karta hai, isliye wo mala ka vibandh karta hai, mala ko it stops the loose motion, it stops the atisa. And vibandhanu is not, it's a different thing. शक्तिर विबंध भेद दोनों मल पारण है कि स्टोर्ड इन भाव प्रकाश शुंठी की जो शक्ति है वो विबंध भेदन में है. इट कैन ब्रेक द विबंध द ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन बट इट डजंट हैव अ शक्ति, इट डजंट हैव अ कैपेसिटी ऑफ मल पासन. सो दो टू थिंग्स आर डिफरेंट, दो टू थिंग्स लुक अपोजिट बट दे आर नॉट अपोजिट एंड दे आर बोथ आर इम्पॉर्टेंट इन दिस कॉन्टेक्स्ट ऑफ दाढ़ी मधुमेह. ग्राही एंड विबंध because you can see that the dadimadhi vrutta which we are seeing is mudhavatanuloman kya kab hoga, mudhavat kab hoga, where when will mudhavat take place? Mudha is confused, so vat kab confused hoga? It will flow in another direction which is not flowing the direction which is expected to flow. So when it will have vibandha, it will have some obstruction, say of ama, of kapha or some another vata. So it breaks, shunti can break this obstruction, vedan kar sakti hai, vibandha ka nash kar sakti hai, and it is useful in mudhavata anuloman, in this context of dadimadhi gruta. The next thing, very important thing is gruta, sauskara anuvartan. This gruta sauskaranuvartan of gruta is not important only for dadimadhi gruta. It is to understand this sauskaranuvartan is important for all the gruta kalpana. So what does that mean, sauskaranuvartan? Sauskara anuvartan, there are two words in sauskaranuvartan. Sauskar, what does that mean? Sauskar is gunantaradhanam. Sauskar is gunantara ropan. So you are putting another attribute on a dravya. Ek dravya pe dusre dravya ke gunon ka aropan kar rahe hai aap. You are putting there. Aap rakh rahe hai wahan pe. So when you are putting such another attribute, it may be obvious that if they are opposite of each other, jispe sauskar kar rahe hai aur jiska sauskar kar rahe hai. Sauskaraka dravya and the dravya which is being processed, if they are opposite, they will have a fight in them and one will survive. This can happen. But this doesn't happen in the case of Gruta. Gruta mein sauskar ke anuvartan ka gun hai. So what does that mean? Sauskaraka dravya chitrakadi, especially yahan pe likha hai chakrapani ki jagah mein, चित्रकादि गुण अनुविधाने अपि सर्पि स्व गुणा स्नेह शैत्यादि जहाती. तो घी जो है, मृत जो है, दैट डजंट लीव द क्वालिटीज ऑफ ओन इटसेल्फ. सो इट कैरीज द क्वालिटीज ऑफ द एट्रीब्यूट ऑफ द द्रव्य. सेम इट मे बी चित्रक ऑल्सो, विच इज वेरी हॉट, विच इज वेरी ड्राई. सो द एट्रीब्यूट ऑफ चित्रक आर वेरी मच ऑपोजिट टू दैट ऑफ घृत. सो इट कैरीज द संस्कार ऑफ चित्र एंड इट डजंट लेट द एट्रीब्यूट ऑफ इट सेल्फ गेट डिस्ट्रॉय और गेट लेसन. खुद के गुण कम न करते हुए, उनका विनाश न करते हुए, इट कैन कैरी, ये कैरी कर सकता है संस्कार द्रव्य के गुण. सो इफ एट ऑल यू आर प्रोसेसिंग इट विच चित्र विच हैज ऑपोजिट गुण, both the qualities of Chitrak also and Vruta also